Hello and welcome to episode 280 of Bobo Scrub Arty Records. Yay! So yes, carrying on with the live artillery gameplay, and I have no idea what kind of matches we're going to have. And as the last couple of episodes have gone, as you've seen, sometimes they can be better than others. So, yes. But seeing as though the last episode we concentrated on the T92, I thought today I'm going to pop out in the GW100. It's one of our newer machines, and I am having a bit more luck with it than the 58. But I might play both of them this episode, and we'll see how things go. So I did move our main German crew up into this, so now they can really succeed in what they're doing. And there's fresh crews in the lower ones that we've kept. So yeah, I'm going to start off with this. See what kind of matches we have, and maybe play some of the 58 and see if we can actually get a little bit better with that. This week, this is kind of the things that I've been trying out. As you can see, the 58, nah, I'm still not too keen on. The GW100, I'm a little bit happier with. I was trying to do some missions in the medium tanks there, which weren't going too well. I've been trying to improve my Panther 88 a little bit, but yeah, it's very difficult to do well in that machine. And the T92 matches have not gone too well, as you can see as well. So, yes. Anyway, enough of me blabbering. Let's get out in the GW100 and see what kind of thing we can achieve. Okie dokie. Sacred Valley. One artillery per side. They've got a Conqueror gun carriage. We've got a much quicker reload than the Conqueror gun carriage. So, if we can keep this gun firing, we could actually rack up some decent damage. Now in the south here, again, you see, I've never really settled on one place. I don't know whether you should necessarily, but I've got a funny feeling our medium tanks are probably going to try and push effectively down the south. So I'm wondering whether or not it's worth us having a ganders this way first. Actually, to be honest, normally a spot happens here fairly soon. Our AMX-30B is going to see if he can get some spots over this way. Let's just get aimed in fully. Looks like some people have already been up this way because there's some broken bits and bobs. Righty-o, so their M41 crashed. Right, yep. Yeah. T-62A has already made it on up. Doesn't look like IMX-30 is in a place to be able to spot. There's a Jagdpanzer. Two Jagdpanzer E-100s. Maybe we can see if we can get aimed in on one of these guys then. So let this aim circle come right on in, and then we'll see if we can get something on them. So here we go. Sounded like it might have penned. There's a medium tank here pushing on our lights. As you can see, this reload time is not very long, so could potentially try and get a shot on him if they move out from behind these buildings. See what we can do. We need to be careful not to hit our light tanks. It's just keep an eye on what's going on. Okay, he's pushing back, but let's just see what happens. Ooh, it's dodgy. Damn it. Wow, look how much help we were. Awesome. Okay, so looks like he's been dealt with anyway. There's a KR here. I think he should be fine. There's a waffle over this way. He's pretty dangerous. And there's a ball sig down there, but we can't quite hit him from where we are. Looks like the waffle's headed down that way as well, possibly. Nope, he's dead. Well, that was quick, wasn't it? There's a 62A. There's not many people left on their team. Look, our guys have managed to kind of wipe them out quicker than we can actually get loaded. So there goes that guy. So there's Jagdpanzer. It's the first guy that we hit. He's now going to get shells coming in from every single angle. There's a charioteer, look. It's up there. Let's see if we can get a shot away. And that hit the rock. Awesome. Right. Let's try and get aimed in on this last little bit then. Nope. 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 Okay. Good game. So there we are. That was a victory. I have no real idea what's going on at the moment. I seem to be having this with most of the artillery that I'm playing. So one out of our three shots actually landed. 614 damage, which was that initial shot on the Jagdpanzer E100, and we managed to damage the tracks of the one next to him. Yes, so for a tier 10, one out of our three shots. Our guys did amazingly well. We only lost one machine. Okay, right, well, let's pop out in this again, see if we can have anything slightly different, and then regardless of what happens, we'll pop out in the 58 after that. Okay, Live Oaks. It's been a little while since we've been here in artillery. Three per side, look. So there's two E100s with us, and they've got a 58, so... Rightio. How much of a chance do we have of the south being pretty busy? Can we get round without knocking anything over? No. I'm not going to sit where these bushes are. I'm going to sit slightly further over. I'm going to risk being closer to the south. Try and help with the travel time of the shells. And also potentially get some better side shots on people that might appear in the city. Now we've got some downed wood here. Whether or not that means there's some artillery over this way, I don't know. Just while everyone gets into position and things like that. Okie dokie. RGW-100 has always managed to land quite a good shot. Look at things. Can't hear or see anything this way, so let's try and get aimed in over this way. E-100's decided to come south, which is an interesting choice. Let's see what we can manage then. I'm not going to move the hull. Excellent. I'm willing to actually push forwards a little bit more. We managed to track the E-100 when we hit him, and then that's given the second E-100 chance to hit him with another HE shell, which is good. Maybe we could do with trying to knock down this IS-7 slightly. We could try and finish off the E-100 potentially with our next shell. Shell away. Okay, managed to splash the both of them. It's pretty good. Okay, the IS-3 has been knocked down a little bit too. There's not too much going on in the north. Looks like our guys are pushing quite well. Let's try and keep getting shots down on these guys then. See if we can finish off the E-100 with our next shell. If he gets spotted again, obviously. Let's wait around just to see if he does. Oh, shell away on the IS-7, but unfortunately it's fallen short. Okay, the T-55A is being rushed. It's not good. ITO. There goes the E-100. Ooh, it's a difficult shot there. Let's see what we can do. Let's see if we can stick around on this IS-7 then. Ooh, the object's needing a hand. Okay, so IS-7's gone. IS-3's gone, sorry. Right. Okie dokie. Just the IS-7 left. And looks like our guys in the north didn't do too well. Right, well, we need to try and move on round, and we are big and slow. We have been spotted already. Let's get the tracks back up. That sounded like it was the IS-7. We're probably going to get shot again. If we can get away, that would be awesome. Unfortunately, we can't. Okay, so we probably shouldn't have taken the shot on the IS-3 and just moved sooner. I'd forgotten how slow the GW-100 is. Seeing as though we don't have half the armour that, you know, this is a GW-100, it's got the E-100 hull, you would have assumed that it would be big and slow because it's got the same armour, but I don't think it does, because I think we'll have to have a look at what the armour things are when we get back in the garage, but... yeah, so you'd imagine it to be quicker if the armour wasn't as thick, but meh. Oh well, never mind. We'll see how this turns out, and then maybe we'll win. You never know. So that was a defeat in the end. The medium tanks that we had left couldn't quite finish things off, and the IS-7 that we should have knocked out but didn't manage to came through and got the last kill. So yeah, but 50% of our shells there managed to land where we wanted them to, and we actually got 1424 assist damage. I think that was from the other GW-100 because he was firing at the same targets that we were, but we managed 1672 of our own damage, which is pretty good. Most of the way up the damage table there, and on the XP table. I know it was a loss, but the GW-100 from our side did amazingly well. Fired 6 shots, and 3 of them actually landed where they... Well, it looks like 4 of them potentially landed where he wanted them to, which was good. Yeah. Okay. And we fired 4 shots, and 2 of them potentially landed where we wanted them to. So, yes. Okay, before we pop out in the 58, let's just have a quick look at these armour values a second, because... you would have thought that they'd be fairly similar, seeing as they were big and slow. Unless it's, you know, down to an engine horsepower thing. So, in comparison, we've got pretty much the same hull. I know it's turned around, isn't it? It's like an arse about face version, I think. So, yeah, you look at the hull values there. Weird, isn't it? You would think that this would be the same. So we've only got a 900 horsepower engine though. Okay, well, yeah, make of that what you will, but yeah, result as is. So yeah, let's finish off this episode. Maybe we'll get a couple, you never know, in the 58. And eventually maybe I'll learn how to correctly deal some decent damage with this machine, but meh, I just, yeah, it's weird. Maybe it's not my play style, maybe I'm doing something completely wrong, but yeah, I'm sure you guys would tell me if you've got some good ideas about what I could do with the 58, different from what I'm doing at the moment. I'm really open to ideas. This is one of the worst, statistically one of my worst machines at the moment, which is a shame, because I was super pleased to buy it. I still am. I'm pleased that I've got it, but I just wish I was a little bit better at playing it. But let's go see what we can do today. So, starting in the north of Pilsen. Yes, 3 artillery per side. Right. I'm thinking of actually heading over to kind of the A3 section. And see if maybe we can get some shots down on some of the more interesting sections of the heavily populated areas of the map. I might start off up here, maybe, and then So we can get some shots across here. Okay. There's quite a bit happening over in the east. We do have a long old reload, so we've got time to have a gander at what's going on. Oh dear. Things could get difficult quite quickly. Not quite sure where the arty sit down in the south, because normally when I start in the south I always end up going over the kind of eastern side. We've got tank destroyers and heavy tanks and things over this way. We are nearly loaded. Conqueror here. Let's see if we maybe get some shots on them. Okay, they are headed back. Not sure whether we'll be able to get anything on this dude. No, not really. Okay, there's 183 there. They're all hiding pretty effectively behind. Okay, we don't want to waste these shots because of the long reload, you see. So, okay, there's WZ132 heading right on up in the corner there. I don't know whether our bat chat's gonna try and head round. I'm kind of keeping an eye on the map here. I'm starting to wonder if these two might cause a bit of an issue. There's one of the artillery. If it's worth us trying to get a shot on him. Let's see what we can do. Never mind. Point blank range. Nearly managed to finish off the WZ, but not quite. Okay. I didn't quite catch if we managed to get a shot on the Conqueror gun carriage there either, but that all happened quite quick, didn't it? Okay, we'll wait and see how this turns out, shall we? Haha, so yes, that was a defeat. Boo, never mind. We did manage to get a little bit of damage on the Conqueror gun carriage, like 11 hit points. Wow. And point blank range on the WZ, so... yes, 1,152 of our own damage by two shells. Yes, so right in the middle for the damage done. How did the other two artillery do? Two shots fired, one direct hit. Two shots fired, one direct hit. Yes, so what did their Conqueror gun carriage do? One shot fired, no direct hits. Two shots fired, one direct hit. So, you know, we're not the only one. Five shots fired, two. Yeah, so, you know, we're not alone in this kind of randomness of shells. All right, then. We'll try this one more time, I think. And we'll make this slightly longer episode. We'll try this again, see if we can have any better luck than two shells. Lakeville. Woo! Encounter match. And we're starting in the north. Right. I'm going to try something a little bit different. Seeing as though we're quite quick, we should be able to get over there before we get spotted by anybody. Which would be good. Let's get right over here. Out the way. Not really going to be able to get any support on the valley, but you never know. We might be able to keep an eye on potential artillery shells whilst we're on reload. Do 20 odd seconds remaining. There's a 268. Have a look at the T-54. He's hidden snug behind a rock. Oh yes, he is right behind the rock as well. And the Waffles managed to get a shot on him. Pushing forwards. That chap probably be able to finish him off, I would have thought. Yeah, let's not waste a shot. Okay, so ISU 152. Let's get aimed right in on him. That sounded like a tracking shot, so let's take a guess shot. That went over his head. Alright, not willing to take another one just in case. Not sure if he's moved or not, so that chap might spot him again. Oh no, he's moving. Tree down. Can't believe that there isn't really anything spotted yet, other than those initial couple. Okay, it's given our guys a chance to set up in decent positions. E75, we're not really able to get some side shots down on him, unfortunately. Unless we kind of back up slightly. Maybe what we can do, hold the right mouse button down, and then we can move around a little bit more. The E75 is pretty much going to cop it anyway. It's an E50M. That sounded like it hit the buildings. There's another one. There we are. Finished him off. Kind of all in one go. Which is good. It looked like we'd done a lot of damage there, but we didn't. We did 119, so. Can't quite get anything on the. Ooh, this I-7's in a bad shape. Not really able to try and get any more shots on them, but we've got two shells left, so let's see what we can do. Managed to get one on him. Good, the Lorraine managed to finish him off, which is awesome. So let's just keep an eye. If these guys decide to push on around here, then we can get some shots. We are on quite a long reload though. All we can really do is watch now. Everything's quite quiet though. The guys are being careful. Still got 30 odd seconds left. Ah, this is not good. We can get some clear shots on the cap though, so let's just move back slightly. If we can get something down here. What have we got? We've got buildings in the way. We are slowly moving back. We've managed to get caught up a little bit there. Let's try and move our way back round. So we can get some shots down on these guys. So there's an M103 around the church someplace. The Jagdpanzer E100 and, well, the Object 268, but okay, let's get the turret moved over this way. How far around is he going to have to come before we can get shots? If he can pull back over this way and let him come round on us, we should be able to get some covering fire. I think we need to move further away so we don't end up getting spotted by mistake. But I think if we can get right up here, then we might be in with a chance. Let's let him come on round. What's going to happen now then? Let's wait and see. The Jagdpanzer V100 is big and slow. If he does get spotted, we should be able to get some clear shots. We still can't get anything on this 268 until he pops back round the corner a little bit further, so the T-22 is managing to get shots on him, so he's being very careful. Maybe our tortoise can spot the Jagdpanzer. We'll stick here for the minute, keep an eye on what's going on over this side, and then make a decision based on what else pops up. Whether or not he's going to try and push on these guys, I don't know. I think once the bat chat's loaded and round here, then they could try and push on him and then clip him. Okay, the bat chat's going to try and get round him. Okay, he's deciding to push on the 222. So there we are, we've tracked him. He's used a repair kit. Shot away again. There's another one. A couple of seconds left. Oh, we wasted a shell there. Never mind. Good. Well, the Jagdpanzer got spotted again over this way. We now have one shell in the spout. Yeah, dear. Yes, one shell left. Is it worth us trying to reload? It's quite a long time. Now, we probably would have headed over towards the cap, so maybe it's worth us getting turned around. Moving back this way. There he is. One shell. Fucker. Right, well, we know he's there, so see if we can not waste this one. Shot away. Now we're on reload. Ooh. Should we rush down the valley? Let's see what we can spot. Looks like our bat chat's going for the Jagdpanzer. He's gonna have to be careful though. Doesn't want to end up facing that gun. Although he's on 5 kills, so he's chasing his rare. This is not good. He's gonna get reloaded before us. Not cool. Okay. Let's just try and stay behind him, shall we? Scary. Okay. 10 seconds left. Oh dear. Oh, yes. Not very good at dancing. Well, at least we survived. So 1,271 of our own damage there. Yeah, 3 out of 9 shots actually landed where we wanted them to. Never mind, but we managed to secure the victory. The Bat Chat did amazingly well, just fall short of his Top Gun, but yeah, you know, he managed to get high caliber, so, you know, that's something. Did far better than we did there on damage. Yeah. Okay. That's how it is. We didn't make a loss, though, so that's a good thing. That was a times 3 for the day, so all good. Rightio. Well, we'll leave it there for this episode. Hopefully things will change soon, and I can bring you some more interesting matches than we've been having of late. But hopefully you've been able to learn something, and hopefully when I watch this back, I can learn something from it too. So, yes, leave a like and stuff if you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next one. So until then, bye!